There's something so magical about this time in the morning when the sun is rising and the flowers are starting to open up. There's dew on the grass, and it's just a peaceful time to hear the birds chirping and the water running from our aquaponics as I spend a little time outside. Making some fresh sourdough bread loaves to have for breakfast and getting myself ready for the day is all something that I appreciate having time this morning to do. With having a 3-week-old, it does not always happen this way, but I am enjoying the moments that I get when I can get myself ready, get some fresh bread in the oven, and prepare breakfast for my family after having spent a little time outside in my wonderful cottage gardens. I think sometimes we put too much pressure on ourselves as homemakers to curate a Pinterest-worthy home, if I can say that. We have so much bombarding us. If you are one who goes on Instagram, if you check Facebook, if you're watching YouTube, honestly, people, homemakers, other moms, we share, other people sometimes share the best of what is happening. And so I just want to encourage you today to do what you can and be who you are as a homemaker, as a mama, as a grandmother, as a wife, as a steward of your home. So right now, as you can see, I am cleaning up the dishes while my girls are coloring. And this all happened after we ate breakfast over an hour ago because I had a nurse. And I'm finally getting the bread put away to tuck in the deep freeze. And things just aren't always as smooth or steady as I wish them to be. But that is part of this season of my life. And just taking the moments to realize that's okay. I think it's important for mamas and homemakers to get some fresh air, get outside, take those kiddos outside, and cultivate the earth. I am picking some mulberries with my 2-year-old and newborn because my 4-year-old is at vacation Bible school. So we enjoy picking produce from the land, and mulberries are a prevalent fruit in our area. And I love making mulberry jam, mulberry crisp, mulberry pie, mixed berry pies, mixed berry jam. And I think it's wonderful that we get this free food from this land. The tree was at my husband's work, so we drove there and picked from there. And yes, I only got about a cup full, but we will enjoy them for the moment, for the day, as a snack, as a topping on some pancakes for our supper that evening, but just making sure we use what is prevalent in our area and from that land. As many of you know, I love making good food for our family, and snacks is part of that. And today I get to make with my little helper some elderberry juice honey sweetened gummy bears. So I've made these a while ago, but it's been a while. But I just think it's important to nourish our families and ourselves with nutritious food, including snacks. And what better way than to make gummy bears that everybody will love and enjoy and have a little immune booster on top of that with the elderberry. It's sometimes it's hard to find time to do homemade from scratch foods, and that is okay. But when I have the time and when I can get my little helpers to join me, I will readily take that time to do so. So I think adding beauty to a home is really important, and it just brings a homemaker joy. For me, adding fresh cut flowers to my house and bringing them into my table, my counters, is something that I can look at and just say, oh, thank you, Lord, for the beautiful flowers that are here today and that I can enjoy and that I can give away because I'm making one of these vases for a friend, and just enjoy this season of what nature and what God gives us in our yards, in our gardens, whether you get wildflowers as well, whether you buy the flowers from Walmart, and just enjoy the beauty that they bring to your home. And it doesn't have to be a perfect bouquet. It can just be whatever arrangement you want it to be, just something that you enjoy that brings that little satisfaction and sparks that joy in your heart when you see it. I think we forget as homemakers too that there are times where we need to rest, where we need to care for little ones and not always just have go, go, go time, if I can say it that way. I had to hold my little newborn a lot today, and so it was just time for me to pray for him, to love on him, and realize this isn't always going to be this way. And also, we as homemakers need to just not bombard ourselves with stuff. So we had a little boy, as you can see, and so we are getting rid of multiple pieces of clothing, of girls' clothes, baby girls' clothes. For me, it makes me feel overwhelmed to know I have totes and totes of girls' clothes that are smaller than my two-year-old in my home, and we have a 1,000-square-foot home, so I don't need that stored in my house and taking up, you know, good, valuable real estate. And so just not being overwhelmed as a homemaker with stuff. Stuff doesn't satisfy. And so what better way than to list this lot of baby girls' clothes on Marketplace? There are sometimes tasks that we have to do as homemakers where we have to allow our kids to play independently. And at this moment, my girls are having a great time at their water table while I am getting some watering of our flowers done. It's been a dry season in South Dakota, as I hear many of you are having a dry season in America. And so keeping the flowers beautiful and alive is important to me, and caring for the land and area that I have is something I think God has called me to do. Making food from scratch, whether it be breakfast for supper or a three-course meal, is something that I do value, but doesn't always have to happen. I am making these sourdough pancakes after my husband got home from work, and honestly, you can't hear the background noise, but it was a pretty chaotic time of doing this task. Lots of kid noises, pausing for some discipline, you know, just things happen as moms and homemakers that we have to take care of and we can't always control. And yes, multitasking is a thing that can happen as well. But you know what? Food was made, it was served, we were nourished for the evening, and that is okay. So supper dishes are finally getting done. An hour or two after, kiddos are all down when I am enjoying seeing the sunset and just going to enjoy these moments of quiet and thank the Lord for a day, a challenging day, because my littlest had troubles with sleeping, and you know, there was just a lot going on that day, but there were so many positives and good things. And I just want to encourage you not to feel like you have to be the best at everything, that you have to have an Instagram-worthy picture or the best-looking kitchen or the best sourdough bread, but that you are where you are at with your homemaking and that you are doing the best that you can. So from a fellow mama and homemaker, I encourage you in that.